100 million years after the Big Bang, these stars formed when the universe was less than 1% of its current age. The hunt for the elusive celestial bodies has repeatedly failed. However, a team of astronomers has made a revolutionary discovery, providing tangible evidence of the traces of the universe's first stars. How, then, did astronomers distinguish the first generation of stars? How did they distinguish them from the myriad others that populate the night sky? Why is this discovery so significant to the fields of physics and astronomy? Before we dive into the discovery, let's assess the severity of the situation. According to the European Space Agency, the observable universe contains an estimated trillion stars, a number so large that it is difficult to comprehend. Carl Sagan once remarked that there are more stars than sand granules on Earth. Recent estimates indicate that for every particle of sand on Earth, there are 10,000 stars in the universe. How is it feasible to discover the universe's earliest stars and relics? Chemistry is the remedy. According to the Big Bang theory, primordial nucleosynthesis started 3 seconds after the Big Bang. It was 20 minutes long. Only the nuclei of 2 main chemical elements, hydrogen and helium, were created during this brief period. The first generation of stars, a population of 3, formed from these 2 elements only 100 million years later. The cores of these massive stars swiftly fused hydrogen and helium into heavier elements. All chemical elements other than hydrogen and helium are called metals in astronomy for simplification. In their nuclei, 3 star populations have fused metals such as carbon, oxygen, and neon iron, among others. When these stars underwent supernova eruptions, they added these heavier elements to the interstellar medium. This enriched medium spawned the second generation of stars, also known as population 2 stars. They had a comparatively greater concentration of heavy chemical elements already. Finally, the demise of these stars produced metal-rich planets. The population is 1 star. The Sun is a prominent example of a single star population. Therefore, we now know what to search for. The initial cohort of stars, or the general populace. 3 stars are exceedingly ancient, only a fraction of a year more recent than the universe itself. In addition, they lack significant chemical elements and are metal poor. Additionally, they formed when the universe was more compact and nearly 30 times hotter than it is now. Consequently, they must have burned exceedingly hot and bright, up to 100 times more massive than the Sun. Despite having a distinct idea of how these stars may appear, astronomers have yet to observe them. This is due to 2 factors. First, most of the population's 3 stars have already reached the end of their lifetimes, depleting their nuclear fuel in a few million years and exploding in spectacular supernovae. Second, even if these stars still exist, they are incredibly faint and challenging to observe with our current technology. We can only expect to glimpse them or their remnants through gravitational lensing. Background objects can be greatly magnified by lensing. Given our current technological capabilities, this affords us a glimpse of previously inaccessible objects. The Hubble Space Telescope made one such discovery when it observed Earendel, the most distant solitary star ever discovered in the universe. Even though it appears impossible to find the first generation of stars, there is a method to find their traces scattered throughout the universe. To accomplish this, we must study supernovae in a Type II supernova. Typically, a massive star leaves behind a compact remnant such as a neutron star or black hole. However, the fate of first-generation champions can vary. When they erupt in a supernova, they can disperse everything in an ever-expanding cloud, leaving no stellar remnants behind. This explosion is known as a pair instability supernova, a theoretical type only theoretically conceivable for the most massive stars. Astronomers investigating Population 3 stars believe that such supernovae from first-generation stars may have played a crucial role in seeding the ancient interstellar space with heavy elements later used to form planets like Earth, allowing the emergence of life as we know it. The remnants of these eruptions may be an indispensable resource for learning more about these ancient stars. However, the light from these mega-explosions has likely dissipated into the distance over time, leaving us to investigate a diffuse cloud containing a complex mixture of elements. However, as demonstrated by prior research, even such a cloud can reveal much information. By analyzing the chemical composition of these clouds, astronomers can infer the processes that produce the elements and obtain insight into the conditions of the early universe. Therefore, while direct observations of first-generation stars may be impossible, the remnants of their supernovae provide a unique window into the universe's early history, and a similar method was utilized in the recent discovery. Using the 8.1-meter Gemini North Telescope in Hawaii, astronomers have recently made an unusual discovery while analyzing the second most distant quasar detected. This quasar contains the second most distant and earliest supermassive black hole known, with a redshift of 7.54. To examine the region surrounding this quasar, the researchers utilized the Gemini near-infrared spectrograph, which separates the light emitted by celestial objects into wavelengths that convey information about the elements present. Gemini is one of the few telescopes of its magnitude equipped to conduct such observations on Earth. The group estimated the chemical abundance based on the observed ultraviolet flux. Additionally, this technique is sensitive enough to measure a low magnesium to iron ratio. Although initially devised for quasars with a redshift of up to 3, the method now applies to quasars with a redshift of up to 2. The team brought it to the necessary redshift value of 7.54. Compared to the ratio of these elements in the Sun, their analysis revealed that the material surrounding the quasar contained 10 times more iron than magnesium. In addition, the iron abundance was 20 times greater than the solar iron abundance. These findings shed light on the chemical evolution of the early universe, suggesting that the universe's first stars were likely responsible for producing significant quantities of heavy elements such as iron. The ratio of iron to magnesium in supernovae was significantly higher than anticipated, challenging the conventional view of chemical evolution. However, this ratio could be explained by the debris generated by the explosion of a massive first-generation star with a mass of 150 to 300 solar masses. In other words, only two instability supernovas are known to produce such detritus, meaning that we have discovered the remnants of three stars from the exotic first generation of stars to form in the early universe. This discovery provides intriguing evidence of stars of the first generation, and may cast light on the evolution of matter in the universe. As stars age, they can provide crucial information about the origins and evolution of the universe. The advanced capabilities of the James Webb Space Telescope will allow astronomers to investigate even the most distant and ancient objects in the universe. By analyzing the chemical composition of these objects, scientists can gain a clearer understanding of the conditions that prevailed in the early universe and how it evolved. Recently, astronomers discovered a brilliant comet speeding towards Earth. When it passes by Earth, it may outshine some of the brightest stars in the night sky. The solution to these mysteries could revolutionize our understanding of the universe and expand the boundaries of human knowledge. Currently, astronomers have captured images of stars, galaxies, and their encounters, and the nebula clouds to comprehend every possibility. With over 1 million images acquired, the Hubble Space Telescope has been at the forefront of our cosmos exploration. Over 4,000 exoplanets have been discovered by the Kepler Space Observatory, some of which are believed to be like Earth and capable of supporting life. These groundbreaking discoveries have galvanized widespread consensus among the general public that the universe is a wondrous creation filled with astounding marvels and mysterious phenomena. Gamma-ray explosions contain explosive energies in the dense regions surrounding black holes. The universe continues to captivate and astonish us with its grandeur and complexity. However, one must know that contemporary space exploration is still in its infancy. The emergence of life. The origin and ultimate fate of the universe remain shrouded in mystery. Our knowledge of the universe is even more limited than our comprehension of the solar system, despite the numerous breakthroughs and advances made thus far. Today, join us as we explore the universe's most perplexing and difficult mysteries encountered thus far. We approach a more profound understanding of our place in the universe with each riddle we solve. Each step brings us closer to uncovering the greatest cosmic secrets. Some may find it perplexing that we can detect exoplanets at astronomical distances, with some residing hundreds or thousands of light-years away. Despite this, there is a notable lack of evidence for the existence of Planet 9. Planet 9, for the uninitiated, is a hypothetical, enormous celestial body that certain scientists believe exists in the solar system's outermost regions. It is theorized that the planet has a mass between 5 and 10 times that of Earth, and an orbit that transports it as far as 20 times the distance of Neptune, the planet furthest from the Sun known to science. Observations of objects in the solar system's outer regions, such as trans-Neptunian objects and sednoids, whose orbits cannot be explained by the gravitational influence of the known planets alone, led to the hypothesis of Planet 9. Therefore, scientists propose that a massive planet yet to be discovered may be responsible for these anomalies exerting gravity on the motion of these objects. If true, this would indicate that Planet 9 has an unusually elongated egg-shaped orbit around the Sun, making one revolution every 10,000 to 20,000 years. To place its orbit into context, Neptune orbits the Sun at 2.8 billion miles and completes a single orbit in only 165 years. A planet orbiting at such a great distance from the Sun would appear extremely dim. As seen from Earth, approximately 6,250,000 times dimmer than Uranus. Although many similarly dark asteroids can be distinguished from one another due to their rapid motion across the sky, this is not always the case. In contrast, Planet 9 would move slowly relative to Earth, making it nearly impossible to distinguish it from a faint star. Sure, Planet 9 may be located using ultra-advanced telescopes like the Kepler telescope. Telescopes detect exoplanets by observing the minuscule eclipses they cause as they pass before their host star. Planet 9, assuming it exists, is not going to do that. Instead, scientists would have to detect the minute quantity of sunlight it reflects to locate it against the darkness of space. It's like trying to locate a needle in a haystack, except the haystack is in space, and you're equipped with a pea shooter, making it even more difficult. You are performing the action while rotating like a top. This begs the query, how is Planet 9 discovered in the first place? If I were to show you this image and ask, can you see a planet in this picture? Yes, that is the planet Earth. But other than that, you may need assistance to identify it. You may already have an idea of what scientists go through. Consequently, it is truly remarkable that early human astronomers could distinguish between stars and planets more than 4 millennia ago using nothing more than careful observation by regularly and meticulously observing the night sky and constructing intricately detailed star maps. Babylonian astronomers could chart the motions of celestial bodies and distinguish between those that orbited within our solar system and those that remained comparatively stationary. In contrast to much closer planets, stars at such vast distances should not appear to be moving. a deductively sound conclusion. Even with modern technology, this observation method can only identify planets closer to Earth. Attempts have been made to detect Planet 9's thermal signatures using infrared telescopes. However, the inquiry has yet to yield results thus far. Scientists pose the logical question, what kind of object would have sufficient mass to alter the trajectories of other celestial bodies while remaining invisible to us? There is the possibility that Planet 9 could be misconstrued as a primordial black hole with similar effects. Although this is strictly hypothetical, we have not yet detected a primordial black hole. At the beginning of the universe, when everything was significantly denser and heated, primordial black holes appeared and disappeared in a split second. And depending on when in that second such a black hole was created, its mass could have ranged from 5 to 10 grams to 100,000 solar masses. If our calculations about the mass of an elusive planet are accurate, a primordial black hole with a mass several times that of Earth would be no larger than a grapefruit, or even smaller than a human fist. Consequently, we have no chance of ever locating it with a telescope if this is the case. Remember that black holes are notorious for their gravitational pull, making them among the most destructive celestial bodies in the universe, from which even light cannot escape. However, even if a primordial black hole exists at the solar system's edge, the Earth is not in peril. Primordial black holes are too minuscule and feeble to pose a significant threat to our solar system. But why did astronomers develop the concept of primordial black holes? First, there was an unexplained illumination of the stars, as if a massive but nearly transparent object was passing before them. In addition, these stars began to momentarily shine brighter, but they also appeared curved, as if viewed through a giant magnifying glass. In addition, when scientists created a computer model of a primordial black hole 5 to 10 times as massive as Earth and orbiting the Sun, the results were eerily like the events occurring in the Kuiper Belt. Too much so for it to be mere chance. In conclusion, a primordial black hole would explain why hypothetical Planet 9 is invisible and does not emit infrared radiation. Planet 9 could also be a brown dwarf, a star whose nucleus cannot sustain nuclear fusion and emit light, according to a wild theory. The possibilities and ideas are limitless. Perhaps a photograph of Planet 9 exists somewhere but has been misidentified as a star. With so many billions of stars to keep track of and Planet 9's 10,000-year orbit, it would be understandable if it took a few years to observe that a previously photographed star had moved. Those searching for Planet 9 are pinning their expectations on a new generation of telescopes, one of which is the Vera Rubin telescope being constructed in Chile. As part of the Legacy Survey of Space and Time project, operations are expected to commence in the autumn of 2023. This 8.4-meter or 27.5-foot telescope will be equipped with a 3,200-megapixel camera. For astronomical purposes, the largest camera ever constructed will be the size of an automobile. With such a device, scientists could confirm the existence of Planet 9 and discover roughly 20 terabytes worth of space objects and other phenomena in a single night within a year. The observatory will be capable of capturing more of the universe than all terrestrial telescopes combined. This can alter our understanding of the universe and our position in it. Or the James Webb Space Telescope provides unprecedented information about the universe's infrared region. This is a tiresome task. The planet is shrouded in an enigma. Despite this, its allure is undeniable, luring only those who are courageous enough to unravel its secrets. Obviously, the ninth planet may not exist, And while the jury is still out on what precisely exists out there, we can be certain that with the technological advances we've made and the dedication of astronomers worldwide, we will one day end this mystery. When discussing the mysteries of the universe, the question of extraterrestrial existence has been a focal point for a long time. Despite our ceaseless efforts to survey the expanse of stars for signs of extraterrestrial life, what discoveries have we made thus far? In 2022, a Chinese telescope detected an anomalous signal with a highly restricted frequency range at 140.604 MHz, a precision rarely achieved by natural means. The signal prompted a broad investigation into the transmission's origins. It was immediately hypothesized that the signal originated from the vicinity of the exoplanet Kepler-438b, approximately 470 light-years from Earth. With only 1.5 times the Earth's radius, it belongs to the category of planets called super-Earths. In addition, the planet's location within the star's habitable zone implies that liquid water may exist on its surface, creating a potential habitat for the emergence and sustenance of life. Therefore, Kepler-438b is a prime candidate for the astrobiology study of exoplanets as potential habits for extraterrestrial civilizations. The probable transmission from the planet was intercepted by the 500-meter aperture spherical telescope SkyEye in Guizhou, southwest China. The telescope was designed with SETI, or Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence, in mind, and had a massive diameter of 1,600 feet or 500 meters. Therefore, it is no surprise that it is the world's largest telescope and can produce 40 billion observations per second. Given the size and sensitivity of the telescope, Chinese authorities immediately deduced that the signal from Kepler-438b was of extraterrestrial origin and represented a manifestation of alien intelligence. Even the Chinese Ministry of Science and Technology reported that their astronomers had discovered several possible technological signatures and signs of extraterrestrial civilizations. Before being reported by the international press, the claim spread like wildfire throughout Chinese state-controlled media and the Chinese social media sphere on Weibo. Suddenly, however, the narrative disappears. The report has been inexplicably erased, without explanation, as if it never existed. Consequently, an international community of astronomers proposed numerous explanations, with radio interference being the most prevalent. Dr. Wertheimer, a prominent SETI researcher at the University of California, refuted the claims by asserting that the signals were merely radio contamination from terrestrial sources, and not conclusive evidence of extraterrestrial life. Radio interference has become a pressing issue with the exponential increase in electronic devices among the human population and the ever-increasing number of satellites in Earth's orbit. Before any conclusions can be drawn, it is essential to thoroughly evaluate and filter out these interferences, as they cause significant discrepancies in instrument readings. Unfortunately, the scenario is common and has led to numerous false positives in the past, causing the scientific community to become more skeptical of such signals. And it's not just some random academics. Even the renowned American astrophysicist Dr. Frank Drake, famous for his Drake equation, was duped. In 1960, when he pointed a radio telescope at a pair of stars, he recorded a strange signal and believed he had made a revolutionary discovery, only to later realize that the signal was merely an antenna emission. And in 2019, astronomers in Southeast Australia detected a signal from Proxima Centauri, the closest star system to our Sun, which is approximately 4.2 light-years away and is believed to contain at least one potentially habitable planet. The crew conducted a 26-hour survey as part of the $100 million Breakthrough Listen project, a global effort using telescopes to detect alien transmissions. They captured a 5-hour flurry of radio waves, and among the 4 million signals they recorded, only B1C1 stood out due to its extraordinary length and wavelength. The team then eliminated the prospect of interference from satellites or other aircraft created by humans. However, the signal's origin remained an enigma until a few years later, when the researchers conducted a more comprehensive analysis of their initial data. This time, they discovered that their automated sorting program had neglected several signals strikingly similar to B1C1 in the past. Moreover, the B1C1 and the signals that resembled it were components of the same radio source, which was likely something on Earth's surface, likely within a few hundred miles of the Australian telescope. Since the signal never reappeared, it may have originated from malfunctioning electronic equipment, deactivated or undergoing maintenance. The crew concluded that the signal's appearance during the 5-hour observation of Proxima Centauri was most likely a fortunate occurrence. Furthermore, this is neither the first nor the second time that a mundane item of human technology has been mistaken for alien technology. Similarly, another famous set of signals once believed to have originated from extraterrestrial entities and detected between 2011 and 2014 were later determined to have been produced by microwaves. However, this is the point of SETI. It's a difficult endeavor. It would be best to sift through much noise to discover the true signals. To circumvent the increasing radio pollution on Earth and the interference caused by satellites in orbit, scientists have always considered constructing a telescope on the far side of the Moon. When you hear that a new alien signal has been detected, skepticism is the norm right now. We've been scorched by false alarms in the past. However, this is how science operates. You must seek with an open mind, even if it means sifting through numerous false leads. Who can say, one day we will discover conclusive evidence that we are not alone in the universe? A century ago, the sky above lacked human interference, but the technology to capitalize on this circumstance did not exist. In contrast, in a century, the atmosphere may be so noisy due to human activity that this opportunity may no longer exist. The current time may be a brief window of opportunity to conduct the search for extraterrestrial intelligence from Earth. In fact, many experts in the field of SETI believe that a significant breakthrough is imminent. Thanks to technological advances and telescope capabilities, we can survey more stars and scan for potential signals with greater precision than ever. This new optimistic outlook for SETI has revitalized the quest for extraterrestrial life, inspiring renewed optimism in the face of the age-old paradox between the vast potential of the universe and the paucity of tangible evidence for life beyond our planet. This discrepancy between the immensity and age of the universe and the apparent scarcity of intelligent life beyond Earth, commonly known as the Fermi paradox, has perplexed scientists for a considerable time. The paradox derives its name from the lunchtime reflections of Nobel Prize-winning physicist Enrico Fermi, who, after pondering the paradox, is said to have famously exclaimed, "So, where is everyone?" Because only a fraction of a percent of the Milky Way's 200 million stars have been surveyed, scientists believe the absence of aliens is normal. Detecting extraterrestrial radio signals, considered one of the key methods in SETI, requires advanced technology and scientific method. The task was anticipated to be complex. However, it is not just about technology. It is also about the strategy. Some scientists argue that we must reconsider our methods and contemplate alternative forms of extraterrestrial communication. There is also the prospect that if alien civilizations send us or inadvertently leak signals across the vast cosmos, they may not be encoded in radio waves, but rather in a manner our current technology cannot comprehend. It would not be remarkable if our current SETI strategy is flawed. When looking at the history of SETI, the original ideas proposed approximately 200 years ago included constructing large flames on Earth, installing large mirrors that reflect sunlight to the Martians, constructing mile-long right-angled triangles to demonstrate our knowledge of the Pythagorean theorem. In retrospect, we now view those ideas as unsophisticated. What's to say that 200 years from now, people won't wonder why we didn't use tachyons or subspace communication? But for now, we are limited by our current knowledge and technology. SETI astronomers remain unwavering in their conviction that humanity is not alone in the universe, despite the discouraging fact that their detected signals have a terrestrial origin. With an estimated trillion planets in our galaxy, many of which are like Earth in size and composition, intelligent life is likely to emerge. They remain hopeful that one day, amidst the radio cacophony we produce, we will discover something extraordinary. The first contact may not occur during our lifetimes, but it is only a matter of time before it does. It is one of the most popular topics among scientists. How expansive is the universe? When we gaze up at the vastness of the night sky, we are reminded of our insignificance in the greater scheme of things. The innumerable stars twinkling above us serve as a silent reminder that our tiny planet is a mere speck in the immensity of the universe. A solitary glance at the celestial canvas above us is sufficient to comprehend the incomprehensible vastness of the universe, which extends far beyond our imagination. It is a conundrum that may never be completely solved, a puzzle that may never be solved despite this magnitude. Yet, the query continues to play with human intrigue. Have you ever wondered where the universe ends? You're not alone. Numerous theoretical scientists, including the late Stephen Hawking and many others, have pondered this issue for decades. In 1917, Albert Einstein made a revolutionary prediction regarding the universe's expansion, a theory he initially questioned until he saw evidence from Hubble and Humason. According to this general theory of relativity, space expanded, causing galaxies to migrate further apart. As a result, when a photon is emitted from a distant star, it travels through an ever-expanding universe, which adds to the already enormous distance it must travel to reach us. But how much has the universe expanded since the Big Bang? According to recent precise measurements from the Hubble Space Telescope and other instruments, the universe is approximately 13.8 billion years old. During this time, a beam of light could have traveled approximately 1,300 quadrillion kilometers or 13.8 billion light-years. Nevertheless, due to the universe's expansion, the most distant galaxies observed by Hubble are now 46.5 billion light-years away in each direction. This distance is 93 billion light-years. Is this, therefore, the actual extent of the universe? To precisely determine the dimension of any object, its shape must be understood first. The actual geometry of the universe has been a topic of discussion and debate among scientists, and a satisfactory answer is still required. Remember that according to Einstein's theory of relativity, space and time can bend and transform. As a result, space could take on several distinct forms. This is challenging to conceive in the three dimensions we know space to be. Substitute a two-dimensional analogy instead. In positively curved regions of space-time, objects traveling along parallel trajectories diverge from their paths in flat regions. In positively curved regions of space-time, parallel trajectories converge, whereas in negatively curved regions, parallel paths diverge. But what about the entirety of space? If space is positively curved everywhere, the universe would be shaped like a giant sphere where you could theoretically return to your starting point if you kept strolling. If space is uniformly flat, its shape could be straightforward and extend directly to infinity. Moreover, objects fly rather than descend if space is negatively curved everywhere. Which is it then? A method for determining the curvature of an object is to evaluate the triangle's angles. If the object is planar, the sum of all angles will be 180 degrees. If the object is curved, the sum of the angles will be greater or less than 180 degrees, depending on the character of the curve. Using the Planck Observatory, cosmologists have performed the equivalent of measuring triangles in our universe by analyzing the spatial relationship between various sites in an image of the early universe. What have Planck and other experiments uncovered? Within a 0.4% margin of error, measurements reveal the universe is spherical. Therefore, can we conclude that space is infinite and flat? Physics is an experimental field of study. However, this also indicates that the measurement is consistent with some curvature. For instance, if we are on an ocean beach and observe the horizon, it appears level. However, contrary to some claims the Earth is not spherical, it is spherical. Therefore, we must bear this in mind. What appears planar can actually be curved. And based on our measurements, the Earth appears to be flat. This is also true for space. The area appears to be level. But what if space is a sphere so enormous that it appears flat, similar to how the Earth can appear flat? Consequently, space is not infinite. Instead, it is limited in capacity. Using the maximum curvature permitted by the most accurate measurements, astronomers determined that the universe must be at least 250 times larger than the visible universe. This equals 93 billion light-years multiplied by 250, or 23 trillion light-years. In contrast, the Sun is to the United States as the universe is to the observable universe. Does this imply that the universe has a limit? Of course. And if there is a boundary, what lies past it? As far as astronomers know, the universe may or may not currently have an edge. Instead, only the edge of the observable universe exists, like a spotlight shining from wherever you stand, illuminating what you can see, but nothing beyond an enormous region spanning 93 billion light-years of consistently expanding space that we can observe from Earth using powerful telescopes. Inside this circle, when we observe a galaxy millions of light-years away, we see it as it existed millions of years ago, not as it exists now. The further we gaze, the further back in time we can see until we reach the earliest light, which occurred a few hundred thousand years after the Big Bang. This is not a real edge, but rather the cosmic microwave background, the afterglow of the Big Bang. The most distant point in the universe is observable from Earth, and certainly the universe's size could always be infinite. In such a circumstance, calculating its size becomes futile. An infinite object cannot be designated a shape because it lacks boundary points that could be used in mathematical calculations. This boundless expanse would inspire awe and awe-inspiring beauty beyond comprehension. Imagine the infinite stars and constellations, each unique and brimming with secrets and marvels, extending into infinity. And the fact that the universe continues to expand, creating new space and future possibilities, only adds to the enchantment of its eternal nature. The theory of an infinite universe is awe-inspiring and will continue to captivate future generations' imaginations. And it serves as a reminder that, despite the chaos of our daily existence, we are but a speck in the vastness of the universe. So the next time you gaze up at the night sky and see the stars twinkling in the distance, take a moment to reflect on the fact that you are a tiny, ephemeral speck in the vast cosmic drama, and embrace the infinite mystery and beauty of the universe. Because it is in this infinite space that we find our true place. Let's embark on a fantastic journey into the void and discover the true extent of the universe, beginning on Earth. The Odyssey begins with our origins, the Earth, a planet that stands apart as the only celestial body in the known universe that supports life. On its ever-changing terrain, millions of unique species flourish. However, only humans have substantially altered their appearance. From this vantage point, the impact of human civilization is palpable, as our artificial structures, highways, and agricultural fields are likely to endure for centuries, if not millennia. As we ascend, however, every aspect of who we are and what we've constructed begins to erode. From this vantage point, it becomes difficult to determine if we ever existed. Our entire history can be traced back to this solitary blue sphere, where billions have lived and died, and countless more will be born. This is the world where everything began for us, the origin of humanity. Our destination, however, is the limit of the universe, so we must leave all of this behind and travel further than any human before us. The first destination is the Moon. Earth is our nearest celestial neighbor and the only celestial body on which humans have walked. Subsequently, we traverse the orbits of other planets en route to the limitless vacuum of interstellar space. Our Sun, the star that nourishes our oceans, stirs our atmosphere, and energizes the plants that produce oxygen for life on Earth, is now one of the billions. Many stars that dot our night sky can now be viewed in their full brilliance, untainted by the Earth's atmosphere, as if they were bright, colorful specks on a black canvas. This is only a minuscule portion of the Milky Way galaxy, in which some stars have exoplanets, some of which may have conditions suitable for life as we know it. However, we must continue investigating these alien worlds, because we have a long voyage ahead, and the Milky Way is composed of incomprehensibly immense clouds of dust and gas, with hundreds of billions of stars, planets, and moons spanning an area of 100,000 light-years, and a monster, a supermassive black hole, is concealed within its brilliant bulge. From this vantage point, we can comprehend the vastness of our home galaxy, which, despite its size, is but a drop in the multitude of galaxies that permeate the observable universe. Each of these gleaming points represents another galaxy filled with clouds of gas and dust and billions of celestial bodies, similar to the Milky Way, now a distant blip. Most of these galaxies contain a supermassive black hole at their center, with some even merging in a gravitational dance. This awe-inspiring view reveals that the universe is not evenly distributed, with vast voids between dense clusters connected by a majestic web of space-time. This is a minuscule view of the observable universe, a page in a book spanning 13.8 billion years. The voyage demonstrates the vastness of the universe and the relative insignificance of Earth in the grand scheme of things. At this juncture, we may question our existence. Our knowledge is limited, and we are unaware of everything. The delusion of having all the answers inhibits our capacity to embrace and ponder the infinite possibilities of the universe as we exist on a minuscule speck of dust floating aimlessly in a vast void of space. Nevertheless, it is remarkable that we can see so profoundly and widely into the cosmos. Nonetheless, our comprehension requires further development, and the explanations for the universe's occurrences are frequently beyond the comprehension of our limited minds. Go with the flow the next time something does not go your way. Just roll with the punches. There is no reason to resist the universe. Life is not about having all the answers, but embracing and appreciating each moment as it arrives. Our existence is not restricted to that of a single individual. Rather, we are an integral component of the universe. A focal point where the universe becomes conscious of itself. From our limited vantage point within our minds, we feel quite isolated from the cosmos. Consider, however, that every atom comprising our bodies originated from a star. And over billions of years, the universe evolved and transformed for us to exist. You were literally created from star material. The universe took billions of years to evolve, transform, and create us. We, and everything else in the cosmos, is minuscule and incredibly special. The universe is intelligent. It's not just a collection of inert matter floating around and randomly colliding. One intelligence or consciousness governs the entire universe, including you. Our limited imaginations cause us to experience ourselves as separate cells. According to Neil deGrasse Tyson, and I quote, "We are all biologically, physically, chemically, cosmologically, and atomically interconnected. We are not only in the universe, but the universe is in us as well. We are responsible for treating one another with affection, courtesy, and decency. Our species and planet's survival depends on our unity, and we possess the ability to persevere. The question of what lies beyond the observable universe can remain one of the greatest mysteries ever until then. Even with all the information we have accumulated thus far, we have only scratched the surface of comprehending the universe. As we conclude our journey investigating the universe's greatest secrets, it is difficult not to experience an existential crisis. However, this realization should not depress us. Instead, it should motivate us to continue seeking answers and expanding our knowledge of the universe. In the end, seeking knowledge makes us human, and our quest to unearth the universe's secrets is evidence of our insatiable curiosity. Let's not neglect the innumerable possibilities and marvels that lie beyond our reach and are awaiting discovery. The universe is a never-ending story, of which we are only a minor. Let us, therefore, embrace the unforeseeable. Let us never cease seeking and exploring the universe's greatest undiscovered mysteries."